wish you a very happy Mother's Day. Because it's Mother's Day today, we decided to do a little special for you guys. And I invited my own mother, and yes, she's here with us today. She's going to be teaching us a treat that she used to make for us a lot when me and my brother were kids. Welcome my mom. Hello guys.
Hi everybody. I
always like that. Happy Mother's Day!
We made sugar cookies, which we used to make when you guys were little.
Oh, those are nice and crunchy.
Okay, let's start with the cookies. It has a few basic ingredients.
I wanted to ask, did we use a mixer when we were little?
No, mixers were there, but they weren't that readily available, so we used to make it with hand. We were like
old school.
The batch of the ingredients, we use flour, sugar, powdered sugar, butter, eggs, and vanilla. These are only the five ingredients which will go.
Oh, and salt.
And a pinch of salt and baking powder. Yes.
Yeah, I remember. Gotcha.
Yeah, well, let's start.
So, we're going to be using butter, unsalted. And we're just going to drop that into our mixer. And for those of you at home who don't have a stand mixer, a hand mixer works perfectly. Okay, my favorite. Time to mix. So we're going to put this on a medium-high speed. And we're just going to keep it running until it creams. And after about 4 to 5 minutes, you'll see that it's light and fluffy. Okay, so these are flavored vanilla, correct? Do we use to flavor them any other flavor?
They used to be lemon flavored and orange as well, sometimes. But vanilla was the basic.
Okay. And what did we cover it with? Do you remember? Like, these days there's more icing and all of that, but I don't think you were that fancy.
No. That time the icing, I didn't know the names, but we used to.
Yeah, we just used to call it frosting.
Yeah.
We'll put it up a notch. As you can see, the color of our butter and sugar has changed, and it's more of a pale white now. And when it basically turns this color, you know it's ready, and you can turn your mixer off. Now, it's time for the eggs. And keeping your mixer on slow, we're going to add the eggs one at a time. As soon as you're done adding your eggs, it's time for the vanilla. We're just going to add a teaspoon of this into our mixture. If you'd like the recipe in the I'll link you guys in the description box below, and we'll also just give you a typed up copy of the recipe right there. Does that look nice enough?
Yeah. Just put the other next thing in.
Which is
flour.
Okay, but before we add the flour, we're just going to add our two other dry ingredients into the mixture. And I have baking powder. I'm just going to add that into the flour. And I have salt. Okay, time to add the flour. So what you want to use is a spatula or a spoon and add it gradually. And as you start adding it, you will see that the mixture is starting to go thick. So I just wanted to let you guys know this recipe can easily be broken down into half. If you don't really want all those carbs, you can make half this recipe and still enjoy it. But if you want everybody to enjoy, we have 4 cookies, so you should make all of it.
Make all of it!
Like us. And can this be made by hand?
It can be. It is going to be a little messy, but everything can be made by hand.
Says the mommy. So all of our flour is incorporated, and we're just going to turn this off. What we're going to do is lift it up, and as you can see, that we have our wonderful sugar cookie dough. Now what me and my brother used to do as when we were kids was we used to eat it straight out of the bowl.
Especially him.
Yeah, I used to lick everything. And if he's watching today, he's probably going to say, no, I didn't, and, you know. But,
we love Shamil.
We love me more. But, yeah, so this is done, and I'm just going to give this one scrape. If you're in a hurry, like we are, you can scoop this out onto your cling film. And not make it a ball, but make it a flat disc. And what that ensures is equal and even cooling. And it allows us to make our cookies faster. Now, and like as I said, we can freeze this at this stage. And just press on it. Make it as flat. Okay, so what we're going to do, we have our dough wrapped in our plastic. And what we're going to do is chill this for about an hour. And as I said, if you have time, you can pop it into the fridge and chill it for, well, overnight? Yeah, overnight. So our dough is now chilled, and we just took it out of the fridge. This was chilling for about an hour. And as you can see, it's pretty hard. Before you start rolling, just dust some flour onto your surface. On top of the dough.
This used to be the fun part for both the kids. They used to love to roll the dough and to cut it out.
Especially. I think we used to fight over it.
Oh yeah. Fighting was always there.
Yes, it depends on how crispy you want your cookies. If you like thin and crispy, then I recommend 1/8 inch. But if you like your cookies a little doughy and normal sized, I'd recommend you cut it or roll it out 1/4 inch. And plus, when you put them in the oven, they will rise as well. They will. So you can pretty much cut your cookies out in any shape or size. And we have a heart cutter. You have a flour cutter, and then you have this pretty cutter. I don't know what the name is, but it's really pretty. So. This is a plaque. Yes, it's a plaque cutter. And then you have a small heart. So you can cut that out. And I'll cut out a heart. And after this, after they're baked, we'll show you how we use to decorate our cookies. We'll do a fancy way, and we'll also do the mommy way, quick and easy.
The mommy day always works.
So take a nonstick tray and just place your cookies onto the tray. If you have a baking mat, you can use that as well. Place them about an inch apart so when they rise, they don't stick to one another. The best part is the leftover dough can be rolled out and used again. Time for the oven. And
this used to be the way we used to.
It just makes it really hot, so that's why I don't like it, but it can't be done. Okay, so it's time for the oven, and what you want to do is want to preheat your oven for about 10 to 15 minutes, and preheat it at 190 Celsius, 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Bake these for about 6 to 8 minutes. Let's just put them into the oven. So it's been about 8 minutes, and our cookies look almost, actually they look done. You can pull them out if you want them a little more crispy. You can leave them in for another minute or two, but we think these are done. And a way to check if they're done or not is, now comes the fun part. Okay, so we're going to transfer our baked cookies to a cooling rack. Just so that they can cool down and harden. And if you have cookies, which is they're soft once you take them out, don't worry. As they cool, they will go crunchy. Or have cookie sugar. Okay, so just let them cool for about 10 minutes and we will get the range. So the cookies are cold. And now it's time for
decoration.
Okay, so it's time to decorate. And I'm going to try to pipe mine really pretty. Oops.
Yeah. Haha.
Mom, so it's okay.
Yeah. Something says mom.
I think she's got the hang of it. Okay, so while we were decorating, we took some other cookies out and we baked these the same way, but we just sprinkled a little colored sugar over them. Gives them a little pop. And here's another one. And this was a freehand cookie. We didn't use a cutter, it was left over. We just shaped it, sprinkled some sugar on it. So, there you have it. Would you like to say anything?
No, wait.
So, is there anything you'd like to add before we sign off?
Please do try them, and don't forget to eat 3 or 4 for yourself. Yeah.
We just like to wish all of you guys a happy Mother's Day from me to mine to yours. Thank you.